Hi everyone, I'm Armozy. Welcome back to another episode of Civilization 5 Deity Twins in Canada with Cool 18.
Hey folks.
So how's the situation?
Well, I'm two turns away from just piecing out of this and not losing any more units stupidly. I mean, the other thing that's not helping, of course, is that I've got the slight combat penalty from being unhappy from taking the city. I was already at borderline happiness. Yep. I'm building Colosseums everywhere.
Oh, but, you're in the negatives.
Yeah. That's
how
not
much?
Helping. Just by three, but...
Oh, okay.
Still, it's not going to help.
Oh, yeah, for sure. But you did take a pretty nice city with a lot of good buildings inside.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a really nice site, actually. It should grow to be quite big, assuming I get my happiness issues resolved. It'll help in 6 turns. I'm going to get my next pagoda as well.
Oh, yeah, that's nice, too.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of which, I also have 400 faith. I almost have enough for another cathedral. I didn't actually get a lot of extra faith beyond the faith that I'm getting from the National Wonder. But that one National Wonder already gave me a lot.
Oh, that's right. And happiness, right?
Yep, 6 mm-hmm. faith and 2 happiness.
That's not too shabby. Okay, where's this Vatican Great Prophet going? I have no idea what they're doing with those.
Oh, hey, scholars in residence in World Congress. I totally forgot that we were actually proposing that. That's still going to be useful, seeing how far ahead Bakal is.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm actually glad that we might get it. Still not guaranteed, but hopefully we can actually get it to pass. That will actually help us catch up. So question is, how soon do we want to go to war with Bakal?
Definitely, it's got to be as fast as possible.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. It's mostly a question of how big of an army we want.
Mm-hmm.
Right now I have 6 crossbowmen. Well, I still need to upgrade 2 more. I'm finishing my first trebuchet in just a moment. How many siege units do you have?
I only have 1 now.
Okay. So we need to work on that a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have a lot of melee units?
Yeah, I'm pretty fine there.
I would probably not bother building too many. Just enough to protect my ranged units.
Probably queue up a treb here.
If we attack Palenque from 2 different directions, it shouldn't be too hard to take it. Just need to take it before Pakal gets flight. I don't think he's anywhere close to getting flight, but we're not anywhere close to declaring war on him either.
No. I mean, I'll piece out of this next turn.
I'd say we need at least 30 turns.
Mm-hmm. Well, and I guess with that... Oh, I was going to say, if I'm not at risk of losing any units, then I could just keep the war going for some time, but I did just lose a musket on the front. Oh! There you go, he's offering me peace. He wants 3 of my cities, which obviously I can take away, but certainly that means he won't give me anything.
Yep.
Let me get back to you on that white piece, though, because I can kill at least 1 unit.
Oh, and one of the problems for me right now is that I don't have a road between Alicante and Rosadir, so it will take me a while to move my new units that I'm recruiting in Attila's court.
Right. All right, let's peace out. But one thing that's nice is I will be able to put units right on the border of Tulum.
Oh, yeah. That's definitely going to help.
Mm-hmm. I could actually have 2 siege units positioned ahead of time and everything.
So you could probably take it very quickly.
Mm-hmm. And I probably will do that.
But question is, can you sustain it happiness-wise? Do you have enough happiness?
That is a good question. We'll see what happens when all these Colosseums finish.
Because then there's also the problem of sustaining Palenque.
That's true. Although, you could take it. You could take Palenque.
Yeah, I could.
Oh, we'll see what happens when we get there. Let's move all these units over here and here. And you move.
But even if I take it, one of us will need enough happiness for it. My happiness is not that amazing. I do have 15, but my cities are kind of small. I need to grow them much more than this. I only have one city past 10 population. That's pretty bad right now.
Yeah, I have two. St. Petersburg and Moscow, 13 and 14.
I'm actually last in population. So that's something I need to work on.
Dude, you gotta carry me.
I'm working on it. I had a lot of forests to chop, so that kind of slowed down my farms.
Oh yeah, that's a good point.
It did give me more production, but it slowed down my city growth.
What now? Dido, come on!
Oh, that was interesting.
Yeah, and the Iroquois haven't fallen, although Grand River might soon.
Dido is getting really aggressive.
Mm-hmm.
Which surprises me, considering how bad they were doing at the start.
Right, I was going to say, Dido often is aggressive.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
But given that context, yeah, you're absolutely right. I guess I don't need to leave any units at all on this front, do I? I may as well move everything.
Well, I'll have industrialization in 15 turns. So that also means if I had enough money, I could get 6 Gatling guns instantly.
Oh, you have 6 crossbows.
Mm-hmm. I actually don't need melee units all that much with Gatling guns because they do have 30 ranged and melee combat strength.
Yeah. The only thing I can't do is take a city.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I can take a city with my one longswordsman.
Yeah, you only need one unit, that's all.
Yep, I could actually grab cavalry, lancer or something like that. I don't actually have horses, so this is one of the rare situations where I would legitimately recruit a lancer. Just to have one quick unit that can take a city, and that's it. The problem is, an upgrade from a crossbowman to a Gatling gun is expensive. I don't remember the exact cost, but I do remember it's expensive.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think it's because of the strength difference.
I think it's over 300 gold. Mm-hmm.
Oh, look at that!
Oh, what?
Pakal declared war on Morocco.
Yeah. Everyone's teaming up against Morocco, it seems.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's not the first time that that's happened. Plus, he's probably got some warmonger penalty from fighting the Iroquois and taking
the
cities.
Oh, yeah. What we should probably do? Denounce Morocco.
Oh, good call.
Because everyone hates him. I'm definitely doing it myself.
How do I... Wait, are we already... Oh, I can't denounce during peace, during truce, can I? Or can I?
No, you should be able to.
I go discuss?
Yeah, yeah,
oh, there discuss. We go. I just missed it in the options. I'm blind. Everyone who watched my videos know this. Rest you. Okay, amphitheater is close to getting done, which means we can put in some riders again. Colosseum.
So once I get a bunch of trebuchets, we could go to war with Pakal.
Yep. I'm seeing lancers and crossbows and a musket. Mm-hmm.
I'll just upgrade a bunch of crossbowmen to Gatling guns. I don't need 6. 3 or 4 would probably be enough.
I'm 16 turns away to industrialization. I'm making 30 gold per turn right now. I could probably do... I might just go ahead and upgrade both my crossbows. I only have 2 left, so... I'll definitely be able to afford that.
Mm-hmm. I'm 14 turns away, and I'm making 22 gold per turn.
How's your science output, by the way?
138 right now.
Okay, yeah, my university's finally finished. I'm at 155. Oh, I should build Oxford. have to figure out if I can time it right for something.
Well, I usually use it for radio, because that's the best use of Oxford.
For radio? Not radar? Or yep. Not flight?
No. To enter modern era and get ideology. Because what you can do is... Hold on, too many trading screens.
Mm-hmm.
What you can do is grab scientific theory, which you want anyway for public school.
Right.
And then, with scientific theory, you can research electricity. That's the only requirement. And then with electricity, you can already get radio. Electricity is the only tech required for radio.
Right. I mean, I suppose you could just go steam power and then use Oxford to get flight. Although you need to get rifling as well.
Yep.
I see what you're saying. Plus, you do reveal aluminum, which is pretty good. Oh, and what's the point in getting flight if you don't have biology? Because you need oil.
Yep, the main point of using Oxford for radio is to get some early adopter tenets.
Yeah.
Because you can get early adopter tenets even on Deity this way fairly reliably.
I like what you're saying. Yeah, so I'll probably just wait for that then.
So what you can do is just time Oxford to finish on the same turn you finish electricity research on.
Mm-hmm. And then ideally, I could do that with spying too, but it's so much trickier.
And you generally want to research electricity anyway, because that reveals aluminum on the map. And with a good city location, a hydro plant can be a huge production boost.
Mm-hmm. Not to mention just putting down some mines on aluminum.
Oh yeah, for sure.
And I got this. Now, the one problem with Pakal being at war with Morocco is it might encourage them to build military units. Military units that are probably not going to die to anything.
Oh, yeah.
Now, they might end up taking Saleh, but I doubt it. Yay, I'm happy again.
Nice.
Not by much. I'm still not going to start growing my cities, but...
Morocco denounced me. Oh, no. What will I do now?
So, I wouldn't mind if Buddhism ended up passing. I don't think it will, but I'm not going to vote against it. And I will vote for scholars in residence.
Yeah, we should definitely vote for scholars in residence. Mm-hmm.
It's really hard to get past because the AI is usually ahead of you and they don't want it. But I think they're going to be more interested in voting down Buddhism.
We only have one vote each, but AIs also have one vote each. It's going to come down to what Pakal votes for, I think.
Mm-hmm. And he proposed Buddhism.
Yeah. So he might vote for Buddhism, since he will want his religion to be the world religion. So that means he won't vote against scholars in residence. I'm hoping that's what's going to happen.
Yep, me too.
And if all the AIs vote against world religion, maybe it will fail.
All right, we have open borders. Do I have friendship with Pakal? I do. When is that expiring?
Do you actually have majority Buddhism or just Buddhism in some cities?
Right now I have two, and Moscow is undetermined.
So okay.
I more or less effectively have a majority of Buddhism. If it passes, and neither one of them did. That's really annoying. It's like the AI knows exactly what to do.
Oh.
With the number of votes.
Oh, that's annoying.
Yeah.
We were one vote away from getting scholars in residence. Maybe next time I can still propose scholars in residence. Because I can propose something right now.
Oh, great scientist. Well, I think I'm going to make an academy with that.
I could also propose World's Fair, but my production is, quite frankly, a little bit low.
Mm-hmm.
And I would prefer to focus on military production if we're going to go to war with Pakal. So I'm going to propose scholars in residence one more time.
Yeah, that seems like the thing to do.
Yep. Someone will eventually propose World's Fair anyway. And we don't really need the diplomatic boost right now, or I don't need the diplomatic boost from it right now.
I should queue up a Circus Maximus. That's what I should do. Oh, My production in St. Petersburg is awful.
Yeah, my production in general is not great. My capital is okay-ish. But it really sucks that I don't have any pastures. I have grand total of one. So I'm not really taking advantage of the plus one hammer that I have on pastures. Because I don't have any.
Do I pay maintenance for roads outside of my territory if I built them?
Yep, if you build them, yes.
Yeah. I started this a while ago, but now I don't want it anymore. It's a lot of wasted worker time. It's fine.
So I'm already moving my army towards Palenque. Just to have them all near Rusadir for when we're ready.
Yeah, moving everything east.
I can speed up a trebuchet or two by chopping some forests, so I think I should be able to get 3 trebuchets or so. That should be enough combined with yours. Oh, I can steal gunpowder. That's actually awesome. Alright, definitely doing that. And now I might send my spy elsewhere. He's still in Marrakesh. Will you want to take Marrakesh in the next 30 turns? Probably not.
Marrakesh? No.
Okay, so I'll just keep my spy there then. 29 turns. It's reasonable. And they aren't the tech leader, so I don't think they have a spy in their capital. That seems unlikely.
Yeah, they'd be less concerned with it. Oh, I need to build another caravan.
The only problem with this war is that I'm not sure if I'll be able to afford upgrades from crossbowmen to Gatling guns. I'm only getting 21 gold per 10, so we'll see. I can probably get 2 or 3. Not sure if I can get more than that.
Yeah, I must have clicked a friendship thing with Pakal accidentally at some point. Oh well. I'll probably just eat the hit. At this point, everyone's gonna hate us regardless. I don't know, it's nice to have trading partners though.
I don't think everyone will hate us. I have very good relations with Hiawatha, so if he doesn't get wiped out, we can use him. At least I'm using him. I don't know about you.
For trade?
Yeah.
And a research
I do have declaration of friendship with him and research agreement.
Mm-hmm. No, I just set mine up.
I can get research agreement with Spain and with Venice, but I just won't have enough money for research agreements and unit upgrades at the same time. So that's the reason why I didn't get more than 2. Yeah, my economy is not amazing right now. Let's see, I can improve some of my trade routes. Well, no, not really. 32 gold per 10. It's not terrible, but it does mean I can't afford 4 research agreements and unit upgrades at the same time. That's too much.
Oh, Mayan cannon. All right.
Another thing we could do a little bit later is one of us could go for dynamite.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe not both, but one of us could certainly go straight for dynamite to get artillery faster. That will make city sieges much easier.
They do destroy cities really fast.
I mean, with artillery, you could probably take Marrakesh pretty easily.
And that's true, because it eliminates the movement problem. It eliminates a lot of trouble.
Pakal completed Red Fort. That's actually kind of bad.
And Dido took Grand River.
76 combat strength in Palenque right now. That's pretty high.
Wow.
Yep. Red Fort is a pretty annoying wonder.
I'm not going to send any trade routes to the Maya.
Okay, I got two trebuchets so far, but I think I really need to get a bank in my capital just to improve my income.
Okay. Well, so, my second one is completing next turn. Technically, I'm working on one very slowly in St. Petersburg. And I can really unlock the growth of these guys everywhere. Even if I'm going to take some cities, I should be okay.
But if you're bringing enough siege units, then I won't need that many myself. I really need to improve my income.
Yeah, I'm at 38 right now, which isn't bad, and I still have to build that other caravan, too.
So, hold on. Who do you have the creation of friendship with? Hiawatha?
Dido? Carthage? And Pakal.
Okay.
Which was a mistake, but eh.
I also have research argument, decoration of friendship with Venice. You could probably get it with Venice if you wanted to.
Yeah, actually, he just offered. I think I may have had it. It may have just run out.
Mm-hmm.
All right, there we go. Second trebuchet. You move there. You move there. You move there. Oh, where am I going to shoot this city from?
Oh yeah, you know one thing we should really get now that Pakal has Red Fort? Cannons. That's only one more tech. Since we both have gunpowder.
That's true.
I might grab chemistry after industrialization.
Yeah, that sounds pretty good. That'll be 20 turns for me, and then I can keep going back up the scientific theory.
And I can really use the production boost from it too.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I'm going to grab that.
What's this? Spanish great prophet. Yeah, Spain is crazy with those prophets. I don't like the fact that there's no dominant religion in Moscow.
You know, sometimes I wonder how AIs get enough faith for all these great prophets.
I know.
Because even with a lot of faith per turn, it's pretty hard to get that many great prophets. Their cost goes up a lot.
No, but they must have a big discount on great people. Oh, I can get rationalism. Yes, please. Nice.
They do have a discount on missionaries. From the religion. Missionaries and inquisitors cost 30% less faith.
Doesn't say anything about great prophets?
Nope, just missionaries. Hmm. There is something for great prophets, but Spain doesn't have that. So yeah, sometimes I really wonder where they are getting so many great prophets from and how. Maybe just a lot of faith, but still.
Oh, good. I completed a great writer for someone. That's the thing I'm not really doing very well here is paying attention to city-states. Ife will fight on the behalf of the Maya, as will Vatican City, but it's out of the way. But Ife might actually be a bit of an issue for you.
Ife? Oh, yeah. It is allied with Pakal. But it's not... Yeah, it might be an issue. I'll probably leave a unit or two in Rusadir just to handle that. We'll see. I'm still not quite ready to go to war anyway.
Mm-hmm.
I would probably just leave a unit or two to defend my improvements. I need four more turns for industrialization. I do hope I have coal. I had way too many games with no coal.
Yeah, well, we had a big problem with that last time, didn't we?
Yeah.
No oil, no coal, like one source of aluminum or something ridiculous like that.
I hope this one will be a little bit better.
Mm-hmm. And what's weird, too, is we're in completely different parts of the world, so if the coal was clumped, you think that we would, one of us would have access to something.
Yeah. So Carthage just suggested the creation of friendship, but I don't think I'm going to take that.
Why not?
She's at war with Hiawatha, and oh, I do have the creation of friendship with Hiawatha, so I would probably get a negative modifier for having the creation of friendship with his enemy.
Yeah, probably. So far, it hasn't seemed minded. Four turns, do the big Gatling gun upgrade. Well, I guess one of them.
I'm trying to figure out where all the city-states are hiding. I'm exploring the map, but I still didn't find that many.
Yeah, well, I still have a fair amount of Fog of War. I do have a scout, an automatic scout, just kicking there. There he is, Russian scout, finally checking out your land and the Spanish land. Oh, steal a technology.
Oh yeah, I didn't really explore the Spanish land all that much. I just know of Madrid, Cordoba, and that's it.
Well, free architecture will be very nice. Thank you very much, Spain. I don't know if I should keep my spy there anymore, though. I would like to put it in Palenque, but it might just fall, so I'm thinking I'll move it to Morocco.
Well, spying on Palenque is dangerous because Pakal is the tech leader.
Oh, yeah.
And at this point, he probably has a spy in there.
He probably. What about Venice? What do we know about their tech? I don't know. I'll go to Morocco.
I don't know much about them, but they are doing quite well.
Although, what did
I have no idea how their tech is, but it should be decent.
Yeah, I have no vision. I don't know what kind of units they're packing.
Yeah, I have no idea. I don't have vision. I know nothing about them. But I'm pretty sure they are doing well. They built Leaning Tower of Pisa, for example. Which is a fairly popular wonder with the AIs.
Well, maybe I should spy on them.
And it's a pretty big city, so it should have decent potential. It's actually bigger than Palenque, 26 pop versus 24 pop. Probably worth sending a spy there.
Oh, well, I'll waste one turn of my spy and I'll move him. Yeah, I do think it's probably better off.
Morocco has a lot of masked men near Marrakesh now.
Oh, it does? Yeah.
I see five masked men units, yeah. But the biggest army is Spain. I'm not the weakest army anymore. I'm seventh.
Is it me? Probably after losing a couple of things.
Nope, Venice.
Venice, really? Not even the Iroquois? I'm actually really surprised. Mm-hmm. Oh, and they took back Grand River. Good.
I think Iroquois are doing okay-ish still, despite the fact they lost cities.
They actually have six cities now. They've expanded a little bit more.
He's getting 44 gold per turn, so he has to be doing fine. Just checking if I can sell my iron now that I don't need it anymore.
I'm sure someone would buy it.
Nope.
Oh, it's probably time to put a cut in here.
Oh yeah, it is. So thanks for watching, everyone.
See you next time, folks. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like and subscribe. Also, leave a comment. Did you know I read every single comment someone leaves on my video? That's insane. Why would I do that? I don't know, but I'll read yours.